Hello everyone. Oops. Let's try that again. Hello everyone. This is Theron. Welcome to Minecraft Maker. We're gonna do some utility stuff around here. So you remember how a couple of my sheep, well, more than a couple, I had four sheep, these two, and these two just disappear? Let's fix that. Hey, you get back in there. I didn't mean to feed you. Yeah, okay. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna find ourselves, where's the red? The red sheep are right here. Hi guys. Oh, there we go. And then I'm gonna go pull the little baby sheep out of here. Come on, dude. Come on. Come on. Come. No. Get back in there. Actually. Unhook you. And let's push you out. There you go. Take the adult. Hey, come back here. Come back here. Yeah, there we go. Come on. And this is your new home. Come on. Yeah, there you go. Oops. And then I need the white ones are on the other end. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing. This is sort of rudimentary sheep 101. Breed up these guys. Have them make a little baby sheep. And steal one of them away. Come on. Put them down here. Now, they won't be able to rebreed right away, but it's okay. Oh, no, no. Over this way. Come on, dude. There you go. Pop. Okay. Now, I don't think they'll rebreed again. They will. They'll want the wheat. Yeah, okay. That's fine. So now we will need to breed these two together and they will make a baby pink sheep. And that's all there is to it. The pinks are pretty easy. You can dye them. You can also dye the sheep. Like if I wanted to, I could have brought two of any color sheep, put them in here, and then go make some pink dye by getting some bone meal and some flowers, some of the red poppies. And then, like this guy right here. And then make red dye out of this, and then the red dye and the poppy and the bone meal will make pink dye, and probably have some over here. So you can dye the sheep, and then you can bleach them with the bone meal. So I do have some pink dye here. I can show you that. Yeah, sure, why not? We'll do it the hard way. What I'm doing by, since I have all the other sheep out to my every single other color sheep except pink, I can just grab a red and white sheep and breed them. But I can also do this. So, you're already white, so I don't need to bleach you, but I need to bleach you. So, do that. Now you're both white sheep. And then I have pink dye, which I can then make you pink. Make you pink. Now I have pink sheep again. Alright, we're done. Little sheep tutorial. Now I have all the different colors of sheep. I have gray, and I have pink, and I have lime. Yellow, blue, magenta, orange, white. Oh yeah, one of the whites is a baby. Black, red, one of the reds is a baby. Green, brown, blue, purple, cyan, and light gray. These are dark gray. Okay, so there we go. Sun's coming up, or sun's gone down. So let me, and then if you ever need flowers, you can just bone meal the grass and you'll get flowers. What flowers you get depends on what biome you're in, but then you can take the little red flowers and it'll give you grass so you can start growing seeds, so you can start growing wheat in most places. All right, and then you can come in here and you probably already know this. Poppy gives you rose red dye. And then if you combine the rose red dye with bone meal, it gives you pink dye. Replenish my pink dye supply. So there you go. You can't, there's no like flower seeds, and the flowers won't spread as far as I can tell. So I'm collecting, I've got samples of a lot of different flowers, but I think there's actually more in the game than that. So, and since bone meal will bleach out the animals and serves as a dye agent, I could keep it in here. But you can generate most of the dyes you need from this. The reason I built the cactus farm, of course, was because I needed green. And the only way to get green is through is from cactus. So if you take a cactus, I just had some. So if you take a cactus, take a couple there, and you can do it in your right in your inventory here. I thought. Okay. Cactus. How do I get green dye out of that? Okay, hang on. Since I dyed my sheep green, I haven't really had a need for it. So how did I do it? Oh, okay, let's figure this out. This is a learning moment. Let's put the seeds away because I don't need those. Cactus is how you get green. Do I have to combine them with bone meal? No. Now I'm very confused. How did I get cactus? How did I get green dye? Hang on a second. Let me go find out. All right. Cactus is a weird one. Let me go grab some more. Cactus is a really weird one. To get green dye out of cactus, you have to cook it. You have to put it in a furnace. This is odd. So this is it's kind of a smelting process. I wonder if this predates the flowers. And you get out of that cactus green. So it's kind of a cooked cactus. But it's a dye, so you can use it immediately. So I've got two of that. And now I can combine this in here and get lime dye. Let's get a few of that. And I don't believe that you can dilute it any further. No, it doesn't get you anything. So go back here to our dye, our flower and dye box. So notice I actually don't have the cactus green up here, but the cactus green and the lime dye. That's how you get those two. Now there's a plant that you can get green dye out of as well, but the easiest way to get it is from the cactus. So there you go. Oh, almost done. One more. Didn't want to waste a whole coal on a single thing of cactus. Now you can't, I don't believe you can eat this. Cactus in real life is actually quite yummy. There we go. Okay, well there you go. So you can get from this gray, black is the other odd one. I don't have any, do I? So to get black, of course, you need ink sac from a squid. I'm not gonna go. Actually, I probably should complete my set of dyes here. Let's go see if we can find a squid. Since I live right next to a river, it should be relatively easy. But black is the only other weird one. Hey, dude. Yeah, I'm looking at you. Yeah, that's right. I'm looking right at you. Stupid Enderman. Hi. Stupid Endermite. Come on, dude. I need your pearls. I made a few ender chests. And it takes up ender pearls. And I don't have that many of them. When I'm ready to go find a stronghold, I will need a bunch. Dude. You come and take my dirt block. And you won't even give me a pearl in exchange for it. So annoying. Okay. Do I see any squiddies down here? There's some. Hello guys, I'm sorry about this. I need your ink sacks. You also need squid ink to make book and quill if you want to write books. So having a supply of squid is useful. And as you can see, when you have a looting sword, you don't have to kill a bunch of them. So there I have 11 ink sacks. That should be enough. Are there cows hiding in the sugarcane here? No. It just looks like it. It's a lighting glitch, isn't it? Wow. Hello. You can light up now. That's weird. Okay. So you can use the ink sacks directly as a dye. I don't believe you need to turn them into dye. Nope. So let's go put some of these into my thing here. And then if you take some bone meal and some ink sacks, and you get gray dye, and I already have some gray dye. And you can dilute that even further into light gray dye. So as I said, I already have some gray dye, some light gray dye, and ink sacks. Red, get you pink. Green gets you lime, right? So that's the diluted version of that. That is white, orange, magenta, purple, light blue. Blue was a difficult one to get too, wasn't it? I don't even remember how I got it. Oh, lapis. So you can use lapis directly as a dye. Oops. So lapis is the blue dye. And that gets you light blue. And then you start crossing colors, you know, red and Dandelions gets you yellow. I don't think you can dilute those down directly. I don't think there's anything that it doesn't get you a... No. And there's multiple ways of getting some of these, right? So then blue and red will get you the purple. And I believe purple, you can take the purple. No, purple's not watered down. So these secondary colors, I guess, don't have lighter versions. Right. So yellow comes from these dandelions. Red comes directly from the poppies. And probably also from rose. Let me see if you can turn these into dye. Yeah, you can get the rose. The roses will also give you rose red. Allium, I believe, is how you get the purple. Yeah, or magenta. So you get magenta. Alright, so I've got magenta right there. So that's a secondary color. Let's move these up. Black, gray, light gray, and white. Magenta. Right. Orange tulip, my guess is, will give you orange dye. Yep. I believe you can also combine a couple primary colors to get that. The purple, there's a lilac, will get you the purple. And does blue orchid give you anything? Blue orchid's kind of a rare one. Oh, it gets you light blue dye. So you can take lapis, right? You can take lapis and bone meal to get light blue dye, or you can use the blue orchids. The blue orchids are kind of rare. They're hard to, at least in my experience, they're hard to come by. So this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. There's two more colors. What am I missing? Cyan. And pink. Cyan. And we got our green with lime. What else am I missing? I know I'm missing one. Orange. Let's go look at, I've got all the colors here. Orange, magenta, light blue, yellow, lime, pink, brown. That's right, brown. I don't get brown. I don't even remember. It's probably mixing stuff that you wouldn't normally want to mix. No. Oh, brown you get from cocoa beans. That's right. So cocoa beans you can use as a dyeing agent as well. And cocoa beans here. So if I go pick up some white wool, plain old wool. So the cocoa beans, I don't think, give you a dye. So this is another case where you use an item itself as a dye. So there's a few of those. Right? Cocoa beans. Brown. Kind of the oddball. So most of these you get from plants. These are derived from plants by sort of watering them down with the white. Cactus you get from a plant, but you have to smelt it. Ink sac you get from squids. Bone meals you get from skeletons. And the gray dyes are a combination of the ink and the bone meal. So there you go. A little refresher. I had to refresh myself since I made the sheep in the first place. I haven't had to relearn how to dye anything. So, because it's much easier if you need a bunch of dye of a particular wool of a particular color, and that's the primary need for dyed stuff. It's much easier to make the sheep than it is, you do it once and then you breed up the sheep, And then you just shear them and you get what you need. Hey dude, get out of there. Get back in there. Thank you. So then the other exception to that, not exception, but the other use for stains and dyes is in glass. And I haven't played around with that. You can see all my glass is regular glass. And I've started playing around with dyed or stained glass in a creative world. And that, I think, has some promise, some potential, so. Okay, so that's your rudimentary wool dyeing workshop. Thank you very much. Hope some of you learned something. Give me a chance to talk out loud and refresh my memory on how this stuff works. And, yeah. Another wart. You can't use that as a dye, can you? That'd be kind of cool, actually. But somehow I doubt it. Another wart's just another wart. Okay. Too bad. All right. Thank you very much. I am going to... Let's see. I've got some... I'm going to go back in the nether and get some more blaze rods. I'm kind of addicted to these things now. They're useful for a variety of things. Making ender chests, which are really cool. If you have multiple locations you work out of, anything you put in the ender chest. So I have my next bow after this one breaks. I have another sort of ultimate bow, and this one's actually better. It's power 5, whereas what I'm currently using is only power 4. So I should be able to one-shot more things. Although the power 4 will one shot a blaze. So the blaze rods are useful. I can make more brewing stands, which would be cool. Speed up the process, although, frankly, I'm not going to need that many potions. Carrying like a health potion on me, you know, could be a useful thing. Like going and caving just in case I get into a tough spot. Certainly, the regeneration is going to be useful when, say, fighting the Wither or the End Dragon, something like that. I don't know. They're going to be a little difficult to make because they require gas tiers, and gas tiers are a little tough to come by. Oh, yes. But the blaze rods can be turned into blaze powder, which can be used to make strength potions, which, you know, could be useful for fight situations. And then magma cream, which can be made from blaze powder and slime, or, you know what I mean. This stuff, slime balls, or can be gotten off of magma cubes, which I've managed to get a few, so I have a few of those. Those can be made for fire resistance potions, which are awesome. So if we take a fire resistance potion, end in the nether, and go up to where that blaze spawner is, I can just stand there and they spawn, shoot fireballs at me, which doesn't do anything, and I go up and just hack them with my sword and they die. And give me their blaze rods, which is very considerate of them. So, that's going to be very useful for also exploring through the nether. And at some point, I need to spend time farming wither skeletons. Because I need wither skulls so that I can do the whole wither battle thing. But, yeah. And then at some point, you also use the blaze powder along with ender pearls to make eyes of ender, which you can use to find and then activate the end portal, which is something else I want to do because it's there, going in and defeating the ender dragon. Ironically, one of the advantages of going and defeating the ender dragon is then you can use the end to make a an ender pearl farm, but of course one of the most useful things for the ender pearls is actually to find it, so I don't know. And there's a whole teleportation thing, which I don't have enough of them to feel comfortable using. So anyway, sorry, just thinking out loud. I'm trying to figure out what to do next. I have a few candidates here. I want to build up a few more resources. I have some stuff. The main reason for fighting the wither is to get a wither star so I can build a beacon. And I have some resources here. I've got a good number of iron blocks, but of course I would like more. It'd be nice to be, because when I start building hoppers and tripwire hooks and things like that, it starts getting expensive. Start using a lot of iron. I need to build a storage silo for this thing, because let's go show you. And some sort of a automated, you know, feeding of cactus into the storage silo, because last time I was out here on camera, we looked and we had filled up the chest. I was out here not that long ago, so it's not going to be filled up, but hey dude, hey look at me. Okay, so our collection chest here. Oh, see, I've got a few stacks. And right now, so I've got these guys. These three are all completely full. These three are all completely full, and I'm currently filling up this one. So this is not, this is going to get out of hand in a hurry. So what I'm thinking of doing, temporarily, is building a storage silo here. I've got all kinds of room. And I've got three between the edge of the farm itself and the edge of the building. I have three, so I can stack up double chest, hopper, double chest, all the way up, as far up as I want to go. And then I just need to... Yes, your motorcycle needs to be that loud. So I can build that up as far as I want, but then I need a series of droppers or something to load up to the top one and let everything all filter down. And then, I mean, this thing is... How tall is this thing? It's like 150 blocks tall or something like that. Currently at Z72... $120, $125. Okay, this little pie chart I've seen on other people's videos, and I haven't seen it on here before for me. Must be some way of doing it. Okay, yeah, it goes up to, up here is up 150. So that means I can stack like, I don't know, 75 double chests. Or so. That's interesting. So it's telling me here that this is a wool block, which it is. Model cube magenta, color green. That's kind of weird. Interesting. All right. Okay. So. Down here. Okay. So yeah, I can get, you know, 75 or so double stacks of, or stacks, sorry, 75 or so double chests to stack up tall, but that means I need like 75 hoppers, which is a bunch of iron, Which I probably have, but it just, then I have to go get it all again. Okay. Well, let me put this way. Okay. Are you stuck? I can help you. See, I can help you like this. Ha! Okay. Oh, he's farther away than I thought. There we go. Okay. Can I get just the green guy and leave the white one alone? Yes. Okay. Sorry. It's unnatural. Green sheep. Who ever heard of that? I mean, this is fine, but they keep escaping. They have to be taught a lesson. Of course, it's just silliness. Just don't need as many moms running around as there are. Nothing personal against the green sheep. Okay. Well, I think that's it. Thank you very much. And I will, once I figure out what's going on, and so I'm sorry. I was making a list and I got all distracted. So, project one, build a storage silo inside the cactus. And then once I have that built, I can automatically load it using some sort of a minecart loading system, I think. But then I might want to have the overflow from that be trucked out over here and build a storage silo on site here. Item number two, I have three spider spawners I found down in my mine. Be nice to turn those into a string farm, especially now that I have cactus to use as to kill the spiders. And then I need to do some more exploring in general. And then I have the witch hut over there. Or that way. Yeah, kind of that way. Need to turn into a witch farm, because that'll get me the redstone and glowstone. Water bottles, things like that, and use for brewing. Oh, and sticks, of course, you can't forget sticks. And then in the Nether, I want to build some sort of a functional blaze farm out of that blaze spawner in the Nether Fortress that I found. That would make probably a more effective XP farm than my current skeleton one. I'm not probably, I know it would. and also give me some blaze rods, and then also maybe build a wither skeleton farm that so I can try and get some wither skulls. So those are all the different projects that I kind of have on tap. So I will figure out what I want to focus on next and start making preparations. Then I will show it to you. All right. Thank you very much. Again, my name has been Theron, and I will see you next time. All right, bye.